الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فأما بعد فإن خير حديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All praises and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whom we seek help and forgiveness. Whomever Allah guides, none can misguide, and whomever Allah allows to be misguided, none can guide. I testify and bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah alone, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and messenger. Amongst the worst matters of the religion are the new things in the religion. Every new thing in the religion is an innovation. Every innovation is a deviation. Every deviation leads to hellfire. Wada a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillahi r-Rahman r-Rahim. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenu. دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Ma'idah, ayah number 3, today I have perfected upon you اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم, your religion. وأتممت عليكم نعمتي, and I have completed upon you my bounty. وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا, and I have approved or liked for you Islam as your religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares this in Surah Ma'idah, ayah number 5. Again Allah says, I have perfected religion. I have today perfected religion for you. لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي, and I have completed the bounty upon you. وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا, and I have liked or approved Islam as your religion. And Allah makes it clear that He has liked Islam for our religion. And today, inshallah, we will address the very fundamental question, what is Islam? And this question is asked by people who are interested in Islam. And equally important are the Muslims know what is Islam, because they are the ones who are going to carry this message forward to the ones who don't know. And oftentimes we find ourselves, we are scrambling for the right answer, whereby Allah says in Quran, as I mentioned, ayah number 3 in Surah Ma'idah, about Islam, that He has liked Islam as a religion, and He has perfected this religion, and He has perfected it or slash completed the bounty upon us. So what is Islam? The root word Islam comes from Sin Lam Mim Salama, and there are 140 places in Quran whereby this root word has been derived to other words. The very meaning of the word Islam is to submit or to surrender. And it shares the co-meanings with other words such as As-Salam or Yusallimu or Taslim or various forms of the same word or same root word, whereby the meaning of the word Islam is submission. Submission to whom? Submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Submission when? Submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always. Submission where is wherever. So that's the answer. Islam is submission to Allah submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all given times, 7 by 365 by the whole life. So by 24 hours. So the contract with Islam, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's submission is 24 by 7 by 365. Meaning there is no day, there is no hour when whereby we can say that we are out of the realm of Islam. And wherever we are, whether we are at work, masjid, university, college, even in the bathroom, we submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by conducting ourselves the right way, even inside the restroom. So our submission doesn't exclude us any other time. So that's the first point. Islam means submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the meaning of the word salam is also peace. And that's what we say, assalamu alaikum, peace be upon you. That is our standard greeting. And it's universal. Any Muslim sees another Muslim, he says, wherever he are, wherever he or she is, whether in the US, Australia, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, wherever, we say, assalamu alaikum, peace be upon you. That's also coming from the root, same root word. Further, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna deena inna Allahi al-Islam. Verily, with Allah, the deen is only al-Islam. So there is no other deen acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala other than Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that further in another ayah in Surah Al-Imran. The first ayah was also from Surah Al-Imran. Al-Imran, Inna deena inna Allahi al-Islam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that the one who brings any other religion other than Islam, it would not be accepted and he will be one of the losers. So Islam means submission, Islam means surrender, Islam means obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet has not left this matter alone. And there is a long hadith in Sahih Muslim that a man came to the Prophet dressed in white clothing, bright white clothing, and he was traveling. He had no signs of travel. So he came from out of town because nobody understood that. Umar bin Khattab narrated this hadith and he said nobody knew who he was. And he came to the Prophet said knee to knee to the Prophet, and he put his hands, his palms on the knees of the Prophet. And he asked three questions. Fa'akhbirni ya Muhammad. O Muhammad, tell me about anil Islam. What is Islam? And then he asked, Fa'akhbirni anil Iman. What is Iman? And then he asked, Fa'akhbirni anil Ihsan. What is Al-Ihsan? And these are three questions that this person asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam responded to him with these three questions. And those three answers are a roadmap for a Muslim. If we memorize this one hadith, inshallah, this is enough for us, for our aqidah and our actions. Besides reading Quran. But if you want to stick to one hadith to change our life, this is the hadith of the Prophet Fa'akhbirni ya Muhammad anil Islam. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is Islam? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded by saying, Tashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Testify that there is no one worthy of worship. Tuqimu salah. And establish salah. Wa tu'ti zakah. And pay zakah. And perform hajj. Wa tasummu ramadan. And fast during the month of Ramadan. So the first answer to the first question was, what is Islam? Was the first question, the answer was, Islam is five things. Witnessing or establishing witness or shahada, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah, and then establishment of salah, and then paying of zakah, and then fasting of Ramadan, and then performing hajj if your health and wealth permits. Man istata, if you are able, which includes health and wealth.
answer to the first question. The second question, فَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِيمَانِ. Oh Muhammad, tell me what is al-Iman, which is belief. He is asked, what is the belief? The answer Prophet ﷺ gave was, believe تُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ, that you believe in Allah. You believe in Allah, believe in the messengers, وَرُسُلِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ, and believe in the books, believing in يَوْمُ الْآخِرَةِ, fifth, and believing in خَيْرِ, good, and شَرْ, bad, coming from Allah, قَدَرَ اللَّهِ. So believing in Allah, believing in the messengers, believing in the books, believing in the ancients, believing on the day of judgment whereby we are accountable to Allah, and believing in what is good or bad come from Allah. These are the six things that Prophet said is al-Iman. This is faith. So this is the profession where we profess that these six things are our faith. The first five things are the Bunya al-Islam, or the foundation of Islam, or the pillars of Islam, as Prophet responded. So Iman followed by Islam. If you have Iman, you will have Islam. If you don't have Iman, if you don't have Iman, we cannot act upon performing of Salah, performing of Hajj, performing of Ramadan, or fasting, or giving of Zakah. So we profess the six things and we follow this with the five things. After taking Shahada, it's only four things because we don't take Shahada every single day. Once we profess La ilaha illallah, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa Ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah, then we have four responsibilities after that that forms the pillars of this religion. And the third question was, فَخْبِرْنِي يَا مُحَمَّدْ عَنِ الْإِحْسَانِ. What is al-Ihsan? So Prophet answered this question, and Ihsan means to do good. In close translation from Arabic to English, Ihsan means to do a favor or to do good or to get to do good with an extra mile. Going an extra mile is Al-Ihsan. Prophet defined Al-Ihsan as when you worship Allah, worship as if you are seeing Him. And if you cannot do that, then worship Him by thinking that He is seeing you, meaning you are accountable to Him all times, at all given times. This is al-Ihsan. So there is one type of Ihsan which constitutes our Ibadah and Iman, and there is one type of Ihsan that constitutes our actions. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan. Allah orders in Quran what? Adl, justice, and al-Ihsan, doing good. You have to be just, and when time comes to forgive, forgive people. So justice demanding giving, getting equal amount. But if you give more something who is deserved, then it's al-Ihsan. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan. And the Prophet explained these three questions. What is Islam? What is Iman? And what is al-Ihsan? And if we inculcate ourselves and our children these three questions and apply this, this is the roadmap of our life. Complete roadmap, including aqidah, including actions. Actions in the answer with respect to al-Islam, and aqidah in the answer with respect to al-Iman. And the rest, the quality of Iman and quality of aqidah and quality of actions come with al-Ihsan. So this is a triple pack that you get together. And then fourth question Prophet was asked, فَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ السَّاعَةِ. Tell me about the hour. When would the hour be established? And the Prophet said that the questioner knows more than the answer, or the questioner knows the same amount as the answer. Meaning Prophet did not know the exact time of the establishment of the hour of the Day of Judgment. Then the questioner, who was Jibreel alayhi salam, came in the form of a human being asking these questions, as Prophet said later on to Umar, that he came to teach you the religion. He knew the answers, but he was asking the questions for the Sahaba and the Muslims to come. And then he asked them, the last question is, give me the isharat or the imarat, that what are the signs of the Day of Judgment? And the Prophet said that naked and less clothed, destitute or poor men will compete in building lofty buildings. And this was the prediction of the Prophet ﷺ, all the signs that the Prophet ﷺ shared with us for the Day of Judgment when it's close, and we see some of these signs are becoming more and more evident. We don't know exact time, as the Prophet ﷺ said, that nobody knows the exact time of Sa'bah. The Prophet ﷺ gave us the warnings. So these three things bring us what is Islam, what is our actions, and what is our accountability. Accountability to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we will be accountable in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment, standing, giving account of every good and bad deed we did. May Allah make us among the people of paradise.
Another thing.
describes a Muslim is same mother but one word difference. Al-Muslimu man saliman nas min lisanihi wa yadihi. The Muslim is the one from whose hand and tongue the whole mankind is saved from. Imagine the undertaking Muslims have for the mankind, that the whole mankind should be saved from your tongue and from your head. Subhanallah. And look at our actions in the end. How are we displaying ourselves as Muslims? Do we keep up with this scale? Nearly 10th or 1000% of this? Can we keep up with this expectation? A Muslim is providing safety and security from his hand and from his tongue.
The whole mankind.
And this hadith is recorded in An-Nisa'i, this hadith Hassan. And the first hadith is recorded by a Muslim. Al-Muslimu man salima al-Muslimuna min lisani wa yadihi. Furthermore, Prophet said, Al-Ghasha falaysa minni. The one who cheats, or one who is dishonest is not one of us. Another definition for Muslim. So these are data points given to us by Prophet that you create this profile of a Muslim. Who is a Muslim? Do we fit in that profile? That's the question. So we have a great idealistic picture, profile of who is a Muslim. Man khatara an-nas. This is another emphatic answer to the whole world. من قتل النفس بغير نفس أو فساد في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا. In Surah Maidah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever kills one person without a just cause, one person, and he creates mischief in the land, he kills the whole humanity. He kills the whole humanity. And furthermore, Prophet said, whoever kills a sparrow, a bird, a small bird, one of the smallest birds, he will be accountable on the day of judgment for killing that sparrow without any cause. So we're not allowed to just shoot animals for no reason. Yes, if we are hunting for eating and feeding, that's different. We are accountable for our deeds, even the little ones. So there is so much accountability a Muslim has. And that's why the Prophet has reminded us, An-Nisa', the hour, the establishment of our, the signs of our, why these are not fairy tales for us to just cherish about or have a bedtime story. Brothers, please move forward because there's space constrained at the back. So please move forward as much as possible. And Islam is built upon rules and responsibilities and structure based on the role. Yes, there are different responsibilities for the sisters, for the women, different responsibilities for men. Different roles. Sometimes men have a right over women, and sometimes women have a right over men. Sometimes they have a virtue over the other, and we always use this popular example. The Prophet was asked, who is the best candidate of my company, O Prophet of Allah? What did he answer? Your mom first. And then he asked again, who is the best candidate of my company? He said, your mother. And then he asked the third time, the Prophet said, your mother. And then he asked the fourth time, who is the candidate of my company, best candidate? And then the Prophet said, your dad. That doesn't mean your father is less important than your mother, but the role, because of a role, Allah gave her more worship over the father. Both of them are important to you because in Islam they are your duty. That worship Allah alone and do not worship anyone else, no partners whatsoever, and be nice and kind and beautiful to your parents. Right after worship, Allah orders to be nice and kind and beautiful to your parents. This is in Quran. وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى Masjid, Allah mentioned, gives a list of people who have our rights upon. Surah An-Nisa, ayah number 36. So Islam has great demands from us. Islam is not just an honor given to us and then we wash our hands and we're done with it. Islam has roles and responsibility. We have to deliver this. We can't keep saying that the world is against us, they are doing this to us. Look at this very basic, fundamental definition of Islam and Muslim and see where we stand. As a whole, Jamia, Ummah, where do we stand? Individually and collectively. And then the answer is yours. So may Allah make us the true Muslims. May Allah give us the ability to stand up with the skill that Prophet ﷺ drew for us. And may Allah give us the ability correct our mistakes and follies and shortcomings, that we have the understanding and the humility to understand why we are doing this, what we are doing wrong, and correct ourselves, inshallah. Inna Allah wa malaikatuhu yusalluna ala nabi ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidum majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم أعن المسلمين والمسلمات اللهم أعن المسلمين والمسلمات اللهم أعن المسلمين في فلسطين اللهم أعن المسلمين في باكستان اللهم أعن المسلمين في العراق اللهم أعين المسلمين في سوريا اللهم أعين المسلمين في برما اللهم أعين المسلمين في بنغلاديش اللهم أعين المسلمين في الهند في كشمير في كل مكان يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا